Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Danish Saleem, HOD of Emergency Department at PRS Hospital, Trivandrum. Today I shall discuss about the worm infection that is found in kids in particular. Parents tend to consider it as a trivial issue, but we need to pay attention to this problem because it might lead to complications if untreated. Hence, I shall explain you the indications, the medicines to treat this worm infection. Firstly, you must understand that the worm is a parasite. It survives on the food and nutrients that we consume. There are different kinds of worms found in our body. There are pinworm or seed worm, the most common parasite, roundworm, tapeworm, and hookworm. So let us discuss today the most common type of worm that infect our body and their treatment. First, pinworm. This is the most common worm. It is also called as enterobiasis. The symptom persists for 4 to 8 weeks. The symptoms are lack of nutrition and growth. Children would experience loss of appetite, fatigue, frequent stomach ache, and itchiness at the anus. Pinworm is responsible for anemia too. This is also termed as seed worm because it tends to stick to the undergarments or the seat on which the person sits, and that is how it spreads. This is like a little white thread. It measures at the most 1 centimeter in length. We can find it in the excreta of the kids with our naked eyes. Sometimes at night, the child might excrete the worm because the female worm comes out at night to lay eggs and pricks its sharp tail, as a result of which the kids would sense a strong itching sensation at the anus. The worms adhere to their fingers as well due to itching. Apart from this, loss of appetite and weight loss are some of the symptoms of this disease. Second, roundworm. This is also called as ascariasis. The symptom persists for 3 to 4 weeks. This worm is fleshy and rounded. Hence, if their number increase, they could cause blockage of the abdomen and child would vomit and feel constipated. Roundworms can get into our lungs, which could cause breathlessness and fever. Third is hookworm. This is also called kokkapulu in Malayalam. This is fleshier and rounded. It causes stomachache, stiffness, loss of appetite, blood traces in the excreta. As such, microbleeding and anemia can occur. The hookworm symptoms persist for 5 to 10 days. When we walk barefoot through the swampy or dirty land, there are chances that the hookworm gets into our body through the skin of our feet. The symptoms include acute stomachache, blood traces in excreta, and losses of appetite. If children pass urine and stool in open spaces, this problem arises and spread to other humans. Now let us learn about its transmission and prevention. Prevention is possible when transmission is controlled. So how can you prevent it? First, transmission takes place in the following ways. Through the ingestion, the worms would stick to their fingers. When kids itch, they might then ingest it through the food and the problem might recur. Hence, it is essential to cut their nails regularly. 2. Undergarments. We must wash clothes, particularly the undergarments of worm-infected children, in hot water and detergent. 3. Common toilets. Let the child suffering from worm infection use a separate toilet for at least 3 weeks until it is cured completely. Otherwise, others too might get infected. 4. Flies. The flies sit on excreta in open spaces and then contaminate the food. Hence, the food items need to be kept closed. Hence, if toilets are used, such problems could be avoided to a large extent. 5th, hand hygiene. If we wash our hands with a soap or hand wash thoroughly, we would avoid worm infections to a particular extent. 6th, food and water. The food must be cooked and heated well, and the drinking water has to be boiled, particularly in rainy season, because the worms might transmit through the dirty rain water and get infections. So the prevention and remedy. Children who are at 2 years of old must be treated with medicines to eliminate the worms for every 6 months. There are certain misconception among people that these medicine can cause diarrhea or vomiting. It's completely wrong. The medicine are given so that the worms get excreted from the body. It might not be seen with some naked eyes, but worm medications are very much beneficial. The child could be given mebendazole 100 mg and is to be repeated if the problem persists after 3 weeks, or albendazole 200 mg for children who is below 2 years once and repeated 15 days. 2 doses of albendazole is normally given. Children above 2 years of age must be given 1 dose of 400 mg, then should be repeated after 15 days if it is recurrent. Albendazole has 100 mg in 5 ml bottle. So for 200 mg dose, 10 ml is to be given. If the medicine are not effective, you have to consult a doctor. This infection spreads quickly among the family members due to the usage of common toilets. Hence, if one child is infected with worms, it is better to give albendazole tablet to others in the family too. All the family members must have it at the same time. 200 mg for children below 2 years of age and 400 mg to children or adults more than 2 years. 50 mg for every kilogram for weight is the prescribed dose for children. Hence, if the whole family takes the medicine, the worm infection and its symptoms would disappear in no time. So remember the medicine names and save this video for your further reference. Share with other members, because there are many people who are asking the same topic again and again. So just to summarize, the worm infestation can be prevented and it can be cured with the help of these medicine. So kindly share this information to everyone, and we will come with another good topic soon. Take care, everyone.